Hello students, my name is Mr. Kiran Dhawale, Department of Chemistry from RBNB College, Srirampur. In today's topic, we are going to discuss about fused, bridged, caged ring systems. In that case, if we are going to see bicyclic compounds, in last lecture we already discussed regarding six-membered ring, when two six-membered rings are in contact with each other or attached to each other with two common carbon atoms, at that time we see the compound is known as decaline. And in decaline, this is one of the compound having two different isomers or possible isomers, which are known as transdecaline and cisdecaline. And also in that lecture, we already discussed regarding its energy calculations. Transdecaline is more stable than that of cisdecaline. But now here, another point, in case of 9-methyl decaline, if we see the structure of decaline, suppose here I draw planar structure of decaline. When we give numbering to this carbon atoms, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So this is the numbering, but here in this case 9-methyl decaline is your example. So we write here 9-methyl decaline. Okay, so at the 9th carbon atom we have one methyl group. Okay, and now we are going to discuss about its energy calculations. Here one question is arises, and that question is difference between potential energy of cis and trans 9-methyl decaline is less than that of difference between the potential energy of cis and trans decaline. Okay, so in last lecture we already discussed about decaline energy. So here in case of cis and trans decaline, first we write here energy of trans decaline. Trans decaline have 0 kilojoules and cis decaline have 2.7 kilojoules. Okay, so how it will calculate we already seen, and in this example also we are trying to calculate energy of this 9-methyl decaline. When we are going to convert that convert that planar structure into the cis and trans, suppose this compound is trans 9-methyl decaline, at that time we are drawing here, this is trans means what? If the hydrogens present on the junction or common carbon atom, if they are present on the opposite side, at that time we call these are the trans compound. Suppose this is A ring and this one is B ring. A ring is fused with B by trans fashion. According to the position of hydrogen atom, this is one of the hydrogen which is at the beta axial, and this another hydrogen which is alpha axial. But when we replace that beta axial hydrogen by methyl, at that time we call this is 9-methyl decaline, and this is the structure of trans 9-methyl decaline. Trans 9-methyl decaline. And now another structure having the cis isomer or cis 9-methyl decaline. So here
we try to write that structure or draw that structure in this fashion. Suppose
this is another example having,
suppose this is A and this one is B ring.
At that time we can see here the protons present on the junction.
Suppose this is one proton and this one is another remaining proton which is present on that carbon atom,
9 and 10th carbon.
Suppose this is 9th carbon atom and this one is 10th carbon atom.
And on that 9th carbon atom, there is presence of hydrogen, but now we can replace that proton by methyl group.
So here we write directly methyl and here we write hydrogen.
At that time you see here this methyl and hydrogen both are on the same side. If they are on the same side, at that time we call these are the cis isomer.
These are the cis isomers. Okay, so we write here this is a cis 9 methyl decaline.
Okay, now we are going to calculate its energy. Okay, in this case you see here in case of decaline, trans decaline have 0 kilojoules and cis decaline have 2.7 kilojoules energy. And what is the energy difference between cis and trans decaline? Which is 2.7 kilojoules. And here in trans 9 methyl decaline, if we go for A ring energy calculation, in this case 1,3 diaxyl interactions are seen. Suppose this is first proton and this one is another one. At that time one proton interact with this methyl and another one also interact with this methyl, which is at axial position. So we write here this is H1, this is H2, and here 2 1,3 diaxyl interactions are present in case of ring A with this methyl. And if we go for another one, in another case when we go for ring B, at that time if this proton is H3 and H4, at that time these two protons which are present on the axial carbon atom at third position, so that they are also interact with this methyl. And you see here 4 interactions are there, H1, H2 from ring A and H3, H4 for from ring B. Here 4 1,3 diaxyl interactions, and it gives 0.9 kilojoule energy. So we calculate here 4 into 0.9 is equal to what? 3.6 kilojoule energy, which is theoretically calculated, and it is 3.6 for trans 9 methyl decaline. And instead of this example, when we go for only trans decaline, at that time its energy is zero. And here this is one of the drastic change because of replacement of one hydrogen from the ninth carbon atom by the methyl. At that time it gives 4 1,3 diaxyl interactions, and these interactions are totally absent in trans decaline, so its energy is zero and that compound is highly stable. But in case of second case 9 methyl decaline, here in case of cis 9 methyl decaline, when we calculate its energy, at that time you see here with ring B the methyl group is at axial position. If we can correlate with ring B, at that time you see here this proton and this proton, as like proton H3 and H4, we see here these both protons are interacting with this methyl group which are axial, so that here 2 interactions 1,3 diaxyl interactions. So here we write 2 into how many? 2 into 0.9, here 1.8 kilojoules for this. And if we are going to see here about cis-decalin. Cis-decalin gives also the ring interactions, and in case of rings, there are so many different butane-gauge interactions. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. At that time, you see here 3 butane-gauge interactions. So here 2 1,3-dioxyl and 3 butane-gauge. So 3 butane-gauge means what? 0.9 into 3 is equal to 2.7, which is already calculated in cis-decalin and which is same for this case. So here 2.7 and 1.8 is nothing but 2.7 means what? Here we write 4.5 kilojoules for this. So total energy for cis-9-methyldecalin is 4.5. And now we compare cis-N-trans-decalin and cis-N-trans-9-methyldecalin. So what is the difference? In first case, in case of decalin, we write here what is the difference for cis and trans. Suppose this is trans and this one is cis. Okay. And here in case of trans decalin, its energy is 0 and its energy is 2.7. So what is the difference? Difference is 2.7 kilojoules. And here when we go for second case, here we write 9-methyldecalin. 9-methyldecalin. In case of trans, we have 3.6 kilojoules and here we have 4.5. So simply we write here its difference is only 0.9 kilojoules. Okay, so this is your answer for the question which is asked in examination. So what is the question? I repeat here, when we are going to calculate or we are going to discuss about the difference, energy difference between cis and trans 9-methyldecalin versus cis and trans decalin, in that case, here we see here in absence of methyl group its energy is 0. In absence of methyl its energy is 0 and we call this is the decalin. So here if there is presence of methyl, at that time 4 1,3-dioxyl interactions are there, and here we write 4 1,3-dioxyl interactions, and in this case also one methyl group is 1,3-dioxyly interact with these two protons only. Why? Because this methyl is axially only with P ring, so that here only 2 1,3-dioxyl interactions and it gives only 1.8 from that energy. But in last lecture we have already discussed about the energy calculation of cis-decalin, and in cis-decalin here 3 butane-gauge interactions. So what are the butane-gauge interactions? If 4 carbon atoms are gauge with each other at that time, and that 4 carbon atoms are present in both the rings. So here first gauge interaction is 1,9,8,7. So here first gauge butane interaction is 1,9,8,7. Second one is 1,9,10,5. Then next one is 3,4,10,5. 3,4,10,5. So these are 3 butane-gauge interactions are present in only cis isomer, not in trans. And that interactions we are here, 3 into 0.9 is equal to 2.7. So its energy is 4.5 kilojoules. And here its difference is only 0.9. Why? Because trans also gives 3.6 kilojoules energy. And here in this case, it gives cis case, which gives 4.5, so its difference is very small. And in cis and trans decaline, which gives more difference, 2.7 kilojoules. So that here, according to its energy calculation, theoretical energy calculation, it gives such a type of difference. And in that case, we see here such type of interactions. Well, 3-diaxyl interactions are not seen in the trans decaline. So that energy difference is much in decaline and less in 9-methyl decaline. Okay. Thank you.